boys and girls. I'm back in my kitchen, and I wanted to talk to you a little bit about combining like terms, because you guys learned how when you are solving equations, you keep both sides of the equation balanced and you solve for the unknown. However, when you have expressions, it's a little bit different. You can't solve for the unknowns. However, you can simplify your expressions. You can simplify them by combining all the like terms to get to its simplest form. So what I have here are just random fruits that I got out of my fridge. And as you can see, if I were to put this together to look like an algebraic expression, I would have one strawberry here, plus two apples, plus one banana, plus one more apple, one more strawberry, and last but not least, I'll go ahead and add one more banana to our algebraic expression here. Now, as you can see, this is quite a long expression. 1s plus 2a plus 1b plus 1a plus 1s plus 1b. I can simplify this so that it's much more condensed. If I did that, I would combine the like terms. What are my like terms? Well, my A's are not going to combine with my B's. They're not alike. My apples cannot be combined with my bananas. They're different fruits. However, all of my A's can be combined, and I can get a 3A out of my 2A and my 1A. My apples can be combined to give me 3. Same with my strawberries. I've got one S here, and I've got another S here. I can combine those, and I can have 2S here. So now I've got 3A, 3 apples, plus my 2S, my 2 berries, and my 1B and my 1B can be combined and made into 2B here with my 2 bananas. So I've simplified my expression down to the 3A plus the 2S plus the 2B. So this is as simple as it can get because I can't combine unlike terms together. And A's are not like S's and they're not like B's. So I've simplified this expression as small, as simple as I can get it. Hopefully that helps clarify simplifying expressions. Good luck with your algebra.